Rostov is courted by a hurricane. These aircraft, as you know, belong to the Royal Air Force, which is an air force which has a historical flight, historical squadron, and which relies heavily on this squadron to maintain tradition and also the pride of the force. The Lancaster was used during the war. It was the most important British bomber with the Halifax. But the Lancaster became kind of a symbol. This was a very heavy bomber in terms of bomb load. Aerodynamically, it was a wonderful aircraft. It was not very difficult to fly for its size and power. It has four Merlin engines, four Spitfires or Hurricanes. This was a voyage. It was a very successful one too. It actually outperformed the B-17 largely, considerably. And carrying ability. And this was used for the Dambusters mission. Wallace had an idea: if you explode a very heavy load of explosive, can we break the wall? The idea was to detect these huge bombs exactly at a very precise point under the water. And direct proximity with the gun itself and create that pressure well. And so for the bomber crews, that they had to rescue very well. Thank you. informed by a crew with Mr. Dunlop and Mr. Richmond under controls. The hurricane seemed to be quite heavy on the controls of its makes you a young man with big arms. Interestingly, even though all those years ago, it still actually was fitted with an autopilot
of sorts.
Enough to hold course.
It was holding course and altitude, and that was a big help for the crews. And also the autopilot could be flown using direct inputs by the navigator, who was housed in the nose of the aircraft, sitting at a table and with plenty of maps unfolded in front of him and his pens and erasers.
Dead reckoning and stopwatches and matching maps is a fantastic feat when you think about it. They didn't have GPS or anything like it. They did have some electronic navigation measures of the day, but they were constantly being jammed and upgraded and abraded by the Germans, and we were doing exactly the same to them,
of course. And by the end of the war, the same unit, 670 Squadron, became a specialist in heavy bombing using what they call the Grand Slams bomb, which were monster bombs. The most fantastic bombs before the advent of the nuclear age. Bombs which were devised to penetrate supersonically into the ground and explode underground and create a fusion. To which you can
stuff, bombs, and a crew, and
that's it, precisely. It was a bomb carrier first, yeah. Then they designed an aircraft around the maximum bomb carrying capacity that they thought they could get away with. And whereas the B-17 was already an aircraft,
yeah,
which they converted basically to a long range bomber.
Well, this one it was a bomb bay plus two wings and the number of engines available, because in the beginning it started life as a twin engine aircraft.
Quite a serious loss of life on the dams raid, and we were doing a show recently at Western Super, and we were hoping to get sadly, he was killed in one of the aircraft that hit low power lines on the way in. But he was the youngest gunner. I mean, often forgotten that these guys also served stuck in the back. Tail gunners, ball gunners, you know, they were out there doing their bit as well.
It's been said that there is a huge film in the making about the Dampbusters and other versions.
Well, there is, and I've seen the Peter Jackson's 12 full-size ground-running Lancasters.
Mm-hmm.
So I know that it's true. When it's going to come out, I don't know. But I know that the dummies have been made, and they are absolutely perfect. You would not believe that they were not flying.
The man who was said to be the architect of the mission itself.